All right, YouTube, so we're back. We're talking about some Final Fantasy VII Remake. And today's video is a bit interesting because what we're going to talk about could be something that's really big in terms of what they're doing with the remake story as a whole with the trilogy. Or what we're talking about and discussing today could be absolutely fucking nothing. So this all started with just a simple observation. The other night, I was watching somebody do like a long-form review of Remake from like 2020 or something like that. It's like an hour and a half, two-hour video, whatever. And I wasn't really watching it so much as just kind of listening to it, had it on the background while I was doing stuff. But I happened to look up towards the end of the review, like the chapter 18 shit, and whenever Sephiroth is talking to the party, in the background you can see the Shinner building. And it just struck me as super odd, I never really noticed it before, that the shape that the Whispers were taking while surrounding the building. This happens a lot, to be honest, whenever I'm watching people do like Let's Plays or just discussing Remake, where I'll see things or hear things, interpret things differently. And again, as much as I've seen this scene here at chapter 18 at the end of the highway, I never really took note of the shape that the Whispers are taking, but it's very, very reminiscent of Omega from Dirge of Cerberus. Now this was something I was never planning on making a video about. It was simply an observation. I threw it in the drafts, tweeted out the next day, but the tweet gained quite a bit of traction and a lot of people found it pretty interesting. So I figured, hey, let's discuss it. So first and foremost, the shape that the Whispers are taking is pretty odd. If they're trying to surround the Shinner building to prevent people from maybe coming in and out, whatever the case, whatever they're trying to do, they're not really doing a good job because there's aspects of the Shinner building that you can still see very clearly. And if they're trying to surround the Shinner building, there's really no reason for them to be like spread out around the top of it like that. But also the top parts that are kind of spreading out, to me, look, glancing at it, kind of looks like wings. If we do a bit of a side-by-side, you can maybe see what I'm talking about here, where they look somewhat similar. It is by no means a one-to-one comparison, for one, Omega is gigantic. It towers over the Shinner building, but that's the thing, too. They're both over the Shinner building. That's what's interesting. It looks like the Whispers almost have wings again at the top. Now, Omega has like three tentacle leg things or something. It has these wires that are connected to the Mako reactors. Again, it's not a one-to-one comparison. Now, in the replies, we were almost sort of joking around about this, like what it could be, what it could mean, if it has any meaning at all. And the thing is, if you think about it, man, when it comes to the weapon enemies from FF7, they are created by the planet, right? They are autonomously created by the planet whenever Genova falls to the planet. In case she ever, like, goes crazy, tries to kill everybody, the weapons will come out to try to save the planet, right? Or in the case of Final Fantasy VII, whenever the planet's in danger from meteor, they escape the North Crater, they don't sense Sephiroth's presence in the North Crater, so they don't attack him, they don't know he's a threat, and they just rampage around the world, destroying cities and shit. And as we know when it comes to Remake, of course, the Whispers themselves are also born of the planet. Now, whether or not they were autonomously made or something created them, the planet created them, maybe some godly being, Minerva, I don't know. I don't know if we have exact lore and all that shit. But the point is, they were also born from the planet and created by the planet, much like the weapons themselves. So there could be some sort of connection between the Whispers and the weapons and the shape that they're taking around the Shinner building that is somewhat reminiscent of Omega, but also kind of Diamond Weapon. I had somebody point that out on Twitter, and that also makes a lot of sense. Point is, they seem to be taking shape of maybe one of the weapons. And to be honest, that was kind of the end of it. Like, this is still before I wanted to even consider making a video about this. But then we got an interesting translation from TurquoiseHammer. And it's kind of with the Crisis Core Union stuff and FF7 Rebirth stuff lately. And it's a Spanish gaming site that asked about whether or not Dirge of Cerberus would get a remaster slash remake kind of similar to Reunion. And in other interviews, like, their answer has just kind of been no. Like, very simple replies. But for whatever reason, with this specific, like, I guess, interview, like, Nomura gave a pretty extensive answer. And one that might allude to Omega being a part of the remake story. So they ask, does this mean we won't see a Final Fantasy VII Dirge of Cerberus remake or remaster? Regarding a remake or remaster of other installments of the series, at the moment, FF7 The First Soldier, and I want to throw this in here, this is meant to be before Crisis, it was an error, it was a mistake, we need a complete remake since it is a mobile game. As for Dirge of Cerberus, his story, Vincent's of course, takes place after the events of Final Fantasy VII. So the most important thing is to finish the remake trilogy first, because if we release Dirge of Cerberus in the middle, people will find out the ending. We'll think about releasing Dirge of Cerberus after we finish all three games, never before. So there's a lot to unpack here. Again, Nomura just randomly gave this like extensive answer that I've not seen from the other interviews. But the first things first, if they were to ever want to do a remaster slash remake of Dirge of Cerberus, they would have to finish the remake trilogy first, which is interesting. But also, they'd have to drop the Before Crisis remake slash remaster first, because it's actually a prequel. It's earlier in the story. So they'd have to come before the Dirge of Cerberus re-release. So that's potentially huge information, too, because they're maybe considering re-releasing outside of Ever Crisis, of course, which is just a compilation of everything. Some sort of like remaster slash remake of Before Crisis, which was this like obscure mobile only game over in Japan, right? You only get on like cell phones and shit back then. Like ROMs and shit exist online. I think there's been English like fan translations, but it was a Japanese only thing. So that's now kind of up in the air, man. There's a possibility that they would want to re-release Before Crisis at some point, some capacity, and that they're also down to do it for Dirge of Cerberus, potentially some sort of re-release of that, whether again a remaster or remake, whatever the case. But it'd have to be until after the remake trilogy is done, because Dirge of Cerberus apparently would spoil Remake. Specifically, he says, if we release Dirge of Cerberus in the middle, people will find out the ending. Now, there's multiple ways you can interpret this. Some people think that it could be that Dirge would ruin the ending of FF7 original, which is Meteor Fall, Destroy Midgar, stuff like that, right? Which would then subsequently ruin the ending of Remake, because we're led to believe that Remake's going to follow the FF7 story for the most part, which I think that makes sense, right? Because I think Dirge of Cerberus opens up with, like, Meteor Fall or post-Meteor Fall, where Vincent's in, like, the ruins of Midgar, something like that. It's been a while since I've seen it. Which I think makes some sense. But the thing is, if that's the case, if Remake is going to follow the FF7 story, well, FF7 exists on every fucking platform. So it doesn't make sense that Dirge would ruin the ending of Remake if it's going to just be Meteor Fall, because you can just play FF7 if you wanted to and you'd still know what the ending's going to be. But also, throughout the course of Remake Part 1, they constantly tease Meteor. We see, like, the same Meteor, like, vision, like, two or three times. And then you also have, like, the VR Shinra building thing where Sephiroth takes over and shows Meteor Fall again. And at the very end of the game, more or less, whenever he absorbs all the whispers, you get some aspects of Meteor Fall with, like, the fire tornadoes and shit. Like, we see Meteor Fall constantly throughout Remake. So I don't think that Dirge, again, would be spoiling that if that's Sephiroth's goal still, to just summon Meteor. Which, while I'm in the other camp of maybe what he's saying here is that whatever happens in Dirge Cerberus would spoil the ending of Remake. And the only thing that really makes sense, at least to me when it comes to Dirge Cerberus, would be the big event that happens at the end, which is fucking Omega Weapon, which is, like, it's a different kind of weapon. It's not similar to the other ones that were created to justify Genova. It's like the last resort of the planet. Like, when the planet's in immense danger, everybody's gonna fucking die. Omega Weapon absorbs all of the life stream and sells into the cosmos, and then Gaia becomes a barren wasteland husk and dies. More specifically, Vincent's Chaos Form and Omega were born together, and he's kind of subservient to the will of Omega, or at least supposed to be. And when the planet's in danger, Omega's supposed to send all life to the life stream, so kill everybody. And then Omega absorbs all the live stream and then flies into the space. So when I hear Nomura say that they cannot re-release Dirge of Cerberus because it would spoil the ending of Remake, my first thoughts is this. This is what I'm thinking. I'm thinking something involving Omega Weapon with the Remake story. I think this makes a lot of sense when you think about Sephiroth within Remake and the knowledge that he has. He seems to have knowledge of the entire compilation, right? Or maybe the events of the compilation already happened prior to Remake, whatever's going on there. The point is, Sephiroth should know of the existence of Omega Weapon, right? He knows that that's a part of the planet. That's a last resort, a self-destruct button of the planet, whatever you want to call it. And let me remind you really quickly, what is Sephiroth's plan in OGFF7? He wants to strike the planet with Meteor, create a gigantic wound, a lot of Lifestream is going to converge on that wound, he wants to absorb all the Lifestream, and then sell the cosmos, right? What did we just talk about? What the hell does Omega Weapon do? Precisely that. So what if Sephiroth's plans are in Remake, if he's trying to accomplish his goals that he had in the original FF7, this time doing things a little bit differently, what if he wants to use Omega Weapon? What if he wants to let Omega Weapon succeed, absorb another life stream, and maybe he just kills Omega Weapon? I don't know, absorbs life stream from Omega Weapon, however he would do it, I'm not entirely sure, but I think it's an interesting idea. And this is kind of the problem with, you know, making sequels and shit, because they usually retcon stuff from the original. But technically, Omega Weapon should have existed when it came to the original Final Fantasy VII, right? So whenever Meteor summoned, and then you have the weapons rampaging around the planet, like, realistically, Omega Weapon should have activated. And probably this time around, it will. Again, it's the last resort of the planet. Like, if the planet is going to be destroyed, if Sephiroth is going to succeed, or is close to succeeding, and you also have these gigantic kaijus stomping around, destroying the planet, why would Omega Weapon not activate? It would have to activate. That's what it's supposed to do. That's what it's literally there for. And we've already seen them pull aspects from Dirge of Cerberus, right? Nero was a part of the goddamn Yuffie story deal. See, Vice is there, but he's only in a simulation, but he's still physically within the Shinra building. We've already seen them use deep ground soldiers and shit with, I believe Remake mentions deep ground, but also Epicenter Mission, you actually fight deep ground soldiers. So they're already pulling aspects of Dirge of Cerberus early on in the Remake trilogy. So I don't see why they wouldn't also use Omega at some point. If I go back to earlier in the video, right when Sephiroth, like, lands on the end of the highway, we get this really short scene where you have to squint to see our party. Like, this shot is specifically putting emphasis on Sephiroth, but also the building in the background. Now, whether or not the shape of the whispers matters, I guess remains to be seen. But my dudes, I think that's where we're going to start wrapping up the video. Here's the thing, like, talking about this and shit and kind of getting shit together to make this video, I'm pretty sure we've discussed this before. Like, I swear that we've talked about Omega Weapon being a part of the Remake story at some point. The problem is, we're a super active FF7 channel. We upload every day, every other day for the most part. Like, we constantly put out content. I couldn't possibly know what video that would have been. I've tried to look on the channel, can't find it, but I swear we've talked about it before. So this isn't necessarily a new concept, at least for us on the channel. But having that confirmation from Nomura, like one of the most important people on the Remake project, that if they were to re-release Dirge of Cerberus, it would spoil the Remake ending, man, I think that gives us some evidence. And I just don't see why they wouldn't use Omega Weapon in some capacity, especially if they're trying to one-up the original FF7 to some degree, because they want to make it a better game. And Omega Weapon is not really well-known. Like, Dirge hasn't been played by the majority of people that have played FF7, so it's like an unknown concept for a lot of people. But of course, I want to pass it off to you guys. What are your thoughts on the thing we talked about? Again, shout-out to TurquoiseHammer. Twitter will be linked in the description below. For one, the shape that the Whispers are taking around the building, do you think it has any significance? Have you ever even noticed it? Because I know a lot of people on Twitter didn't seem to notice it either. Now, does it matter at all? Is it just an obscure shape that doesn't have any meaning? Are they teasing towards like the weapons in the future at some point? Omega weapon, diamond weapon, whoever? And what are your thoughts on Sephiroth potentially in the future trying to use Omega weapon to his advantage? Let Omega weapon do all the heavy lifting, absorbing all the live stream. He's got to kill Omega weapon, which he could probably do relatively easy, I imagine. But my dudes, that is going to be the video. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, give a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you guys are new to today. More Final Fantasy VII Remake Trilogy content. Turn on notifications. Follow me on Twitter, @JYT, at my Discord. Links to social networks are in the description and in the outro. Later, guys. Used to care what people thought, but now I care more. I mean, nobody out here's got it figured out. So therefore, I've lost all hope of a happy ending, depending on whether or not it's worth it. So insecure, no one's perfect. We spend it with no shame. We blow that like Coltrane. We in here like Low Game, or leave it like Cobain.